Hello students, our lesson today is on contextual clues. I am Mufid Irshad and I am attached to the business communication unit. I have divided this lesson into sessions. In session one, I will be outlining the objectives of this lesson and telling you what context clues are. In session two, I will show you the major types of context clues and discuss the definition, explanation, context clue. In session three, we'll be looking at synonym clues. In session four, we will be looking at antonym or contrast clues and comparison clues. In session five, example clues. In session six, punctuation clues. In session seven, inference clues. In session eight, cause and effect clues and word parts or affixes clues. In session nine, we'll be doing some practice activities. I will be uploading these activities to LMS also. And then in session 10, we'll be discussing the answers. And finally, in session 11, we'll be reflecting on the lesson. Right, you must be wondering why I have divided this lesson into sessions. The reason why I have divided the lesson into sessions is for easy reference. So, for instance, if you are not sure as to what inference clues are, all you have to do is to watch session 7. All right, let's move on to session 1 now. First and foremost, let me spell out the learning objectives. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to deduce or to figure out the meaning of unfamiliar words, phrases in texts written or printed using context clues. You will also be able to use different types of contextual clues to read a text more effectively. Tell me, what do you do when you come across a difficult word while you're reading? Do you look it up in the dictionary? Search for its meaning on the internet? Or ignore the word and continue reading? Write your answer in the chat box. I'll give you pause the video and write the answer in the chat box. I hope you have written your answer in the chat box. Right, please note, if you are reading to get a general idea of what the writer is saying, that is skimming the text to understand the main points, you're already familiar with the terms skimming, scanning, aren't you? Because we have done a lesson on skimming and scanning, so I'm sure you're familiar with the term skimming and scanning. So if you're reading to get a general idea of what the writer is saying, that is skimming the text to understand the main points, you don't need to know the meaning of every word. Remember, you don't need to know the meaning of every word. If you're reading for specific information or scanning the text, you only need to know the words that are connected to the answer you're looking for. But if you are reading for details, that is reading for understanding, then you actually do need to know what each word means. Please keep that in mind. Did you know that you can usually work out the meaning of most unfamiliar words from context clues? You must be wondering what context clues are, right? All right, let us now try and understand what context clues are and how to figure out the meaning of difficult words using them. What are context clues? Do you know what context means in the first place? It's a word. The context can be a word or a set of words that surrounds another word, phrase, or sentence. It's the surrounding, right? Whatever that surrounds a word is its context. What are clues then? Clues are hints that the author gives you to figure out the meaning of the difficult or unknown word. Look at this example. Say, for instance, if the unfamiliar word or the word is dynamic, those words that come before dynamic and the ones that come after dynamic could be considered context. So the context of dynamics is, or dynamic is, this as well as this. I'll use a picture to show you what context means and to tell you why it is important, why it is useful to know to use context clues. Can you tell me what this is? Look at it, stare at it all day long, wonder what it is, and I don't think you will still be able to figure out what it is. I'm sure you're going to have a difficult time figuring out what it is, isn't it? Well, do you think it will help to see the picture's context? What is around this picture? That is, use context clues to identify what this picture is. Yes? Okay, I'm going to show you the context now of this picture, to emphasize on the fact that context matters. This is the picture. This is what it is. You can see how useful context clues are, can't you? When you see what is around a picture or a word, you get a clear idea of what it is or what it means. That is why it is important to know what the major types of context clues are and how to use them to interpret the meaning of unfamiliar words. This picture also shows you how important context is, because it helps us understand the full meaning of what someone is saying or reading. What happens if we do not consider the context? Say you see only this part of the picture, or you are shown only this frame. You will only see a certain section of the idea or the picture. So in order to understand the whole picture or the idea, or what the writer is trying to convey, you need to know the context. So context matters. Please keep that in mind. I have come to the end of this session. Let me end this session by reminding you once again what context clues are. They are words, phrases, expressions, sentences, paragraphs that help you figure out or understand the meaning of difficult words in texts. All right, so you know what context clues are, right? Now, well, next time you come across a difficult word while reading for understanding, first see if you can figure out the meaning from context, okay? All right, so we have come to the end of session 1. See you in session 2. Thank you.